Sticking with politics, an independent MP, Zali Steggall, has come under fire for failing to declare a $100,000 donation from coal investor John Kinghorn's family trust. Steggall received 8 donation pledges, all below the declaration limit. But a review by the Australian Electoral Commission found they were delivered as a single cheque. Steggall's office amended the donation declaration in January last year.
The member for Warringah, Zali Steggall, joins us now. Zali, your fight to address climate change is no secret. It's the whole basis of your platform. Yet here you've accepted a donation from a family whose fortune was built on coal. Why didn't you seek to return the money when you discovered the donor?
Well, because I accepted donations from individuals who live in my electorate. They have, in fact, divested from their major interests in coal over 10 years ago. But also, it's not about recriminating against people for their past conduct. I welcome people who, you know, come to their senses and realise we need to transition away from supporting fossil fuels to supporting renewable energy and a clean transition. So most Australians have at one time or another supported fossil fuels. And it's not about pointing the finger or blaming, but it is about moving towards where our future opportunities are. And so in that sense, I welcome the donations.
But Zali, we're talking about a very high-profile former board member of a coal company who sold it to make a fortune. You made the point in your statement that anyone who donates to you probably has some coal connection because of super. They're two very different things, surely.
Well, no. And again...
Well, yes, they are.
Well, no, they're not.
Well, John Kinghorn is a very well-known director of a coal mining company. He made his fortune out of it. The money that you got into your campaign coffers came from the sale of that company to a Chinese company who now run the coal business.
Are you interested in my answer or you want to tell me what you think?
I'd like an accurate answer.
Well, let me tell you again.
Please.
No, well, with respect. Again, whether they have supported coal and fossil fuels in the past is not the point. The point is they are now putting their money to good use in actually supporting a transition to renewable energy. Now, if I was in Parliament advocating to maintain support for fossil fuels, then I agree there would be a question to answer, because whilst pushing a platform of climate action, I would be acting contrary here in the House. But I don't. I very much support that we transition to renewables and that we have strong climate action.
The other limb of this is the political donations side of it and the transparency of those sorts of things. You've been a big proponent of political donation reform. This is a $100,000 donation that's posing as something else, as 8 individual contributions. Isn't that exactly the kind of thing that you stand against?
Look, I strongly support that we increase transparency, that we lower donation thresholds. I support real-time donation reporting. I've moved amendments and I've moved bills in the House to that effect. The reality here, I had 8 members of a large family who signed pledges to make individual donations. When the error was found that they had in fact done so by one cheque and the AEC brought it to my attention, Warringah Independence at that point amended the response. I think what you should note, this has been on the public record since February 2021, over 12 months ago. So I think it begs the question, why are we pulling this and why is this a front page story now?
And why do you think it is?
Well, I think it's because there's real issues. The government is under challenge on their failure to introduce a Federal Integrity Commission, and they are under challenge for their climate record in a number of seats where independents are challenging them. So they are pulling out the dirty tricks and the misleading headlines with friendly papers. So, look, I'll cop it. I'm very happy we corrected the record as soon as it was necessary. I am here explaining. I have nothing to hide.
I'm glad you say you're willing to cop it, because I've got just a couple more questions that I wouldn't mind going through. So when you say that this was 8 different people who made these donations, they're members of the same family, and then you later discovered it, and at the point you discovered it, you were prepared to report it. I understand that, but at the same time, that $100,000 cheque was, I understand, actually by quite some distance, the largest donation that your campaign received. And as such, wouldn't it be exactly the kind of thing that should have caused you or your team to take notice?
Well, the difficulty is there was a mistake made by from an accounting point of view by the team. The cheque was provided to Warringah Independence, and as soon as I became aware of it, it was rectified. Because at the end of the day, we have 8 pledge forms identifying where those donations are. This is not a question of I have failed to disclose that I have received $100,000. I have absolutely disclosed
sure.
that.
No, no,
the
I'm
headline
not,
of the I'm, papers is misleading.
I'm not talking about a failure to disclose. I'm more talking about a lack of due diligence, I suppose. So I only use the word mistake because that's the word that you were using. When a $100,000 cheque turns up and that is outsized compared to the other donations that you're getting, I just would have thought the obvious thing to do, especially if you care about things like political donation reform, is to investigate that and then to report what you find.
And absolutely. As soon as it was brought to my attention, I absolutely investigated it, and we amended, the Warringah Independence amended the return, and that has been on the public record since February 2021.
Well, Zali, good luck on the campaign trail, and it was good to chat tonight.
Thank you.